The reading of the word of the Lord. Can you see that? No, taken from or inside the car. No, facing your windshield with your rear mirror, and showing in the photo alone, you can conclude that there's a wider view looking at the windshield rather than looking at the rear mirror that you have. It means to say it's more brighter, and you must focus your future and not the past. Hallelujah. The title for tonight, Greater Things Ahead Than Any You Leave Behind. Amen, Badon? Shall we say amen? Amen. Greater things ahead? Amen? Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 35, verses 1 and 10. And please read with me. The wilderness and the wasteland shall be glad for them, and the desert shall rejoice and blossom as the rose. It shall blossom abundantly and rejoice, even with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the excellence of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the excellency of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are fearful-hearted, be strong. Do not fear. Behold, your God will come with vengeance. With the recompense of God, he will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf shall be unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the dumb sing. And water shall burst forth in the wilderness, streams in the deserts. And the parched ground shall become a pool, and the thirsty land spring of water. In the habitation of jackals, where each lay, there shall be grass with reeds and rushes. A highway shall be there, and a road, and it shall be called the highway of holiness. And the unclean shall not pass over it, but it shall be for others. Whoever walks the road, although a fool, shall not go astray. No lion shall be there, nor shall a ravenous beast go up on it. It shall not be found there, but the redeemed shall the Lord shall return, and to come to Zion with singing, with everlasting joy on their head. They shall obtain joy, gladness, and sorrow and singing shall flee. Hallelujah. Thank you for the reading of the word of the Lord. You may all be seated in his very presence. Thank you. Hallelujah. Shall you give a tap to your neighbor and just said, Happy New Year. Amen. Actually, this is the vision of Isaiah to the future stake that all the believers will possess. This is the revelation coming from God that this is this will be the possession and the joy that will be given to all of you. To all those who believe in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will have this promise. But I believe that as God promised and as God placed that into the very word in this Bible, we can now possess such promise, because later on I will just relate that in the New Testament. As what we read, he says here, the wilderness and the wasteland shall be glad for them, to those who believe in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This is the future stake. This is the promise of God. Even those wasteland and wilderness which has no life at all will have life in that time. They will be rejoicing to see you coming in the very presence of God. Hallelujah. Are you excited? You know, I am so excited because when I talked to my wife, I told her, what can I share to the people this new year? And she gives me some insight, and I say, okay, greater things ahead. Greater things in this 2016. And it says, it shall blossom abundantly and rejoice, even with joy and singing. So, not only in the coming time that the Lord set for us, we can enjoy all these things that comes from God. Only if we hold on by heart the promises of the Lord, it will come and it will manifest. That's what I believe in the word of God. Just like what we sang a while ago, glad it's here, it's a prophetic song. No, the song says that you can see the very face of the Lord. How can you see the very face of God if it's not be in the future? But this is prophetic. You're already possessing something in your spirit. Hallelujah. When you praise God, you can see the very glory of God. This is also true in the word that we are reading right now. The glory of Lebanon, how popular was Lebanon, shall be given to the believer. Hallelujah. You will be great in the sight of God. Every one of us will be made known in the very minds and heart of God. Hallelujah. Like Lebanon at the time, so popular, so great. Hallelujah. They built a highest tower. That's how great they are. But in the sight of God and in the heart of God, these people who receive me as their Lord and personal Savior, this is the future stake. This is what I will be given to them in the future. You will be great in the heart of God. They shall see the glory of the Lord. This is magnificent. This is the one that I'm waiting for, to see the very glory of Jesus Christ, to see how glorious the face, hallelujah, the shining glory of God, how it looks like, the excellency of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feebleness. Encourage one another. The day, the time will come that we will experience this. But before the coming of that future, before the coming of that promise of God, we can possess it now. Hallelujah. Just like saying you have your eternal life starts when you receive Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. So why wait for the time that you will be in heaven to start the eternal life? It begins when you receive Jesus, and the same manner with this word. Hallelujah. Say to those who are fearful hearted, those who have that reverence in God, this is what is said. Be strong. Do not fear. Behold, your God come with vengeance. Everything will be given to God. Hallelujah. We will just rely on the Lord. We will just cling and hold on to the strength of God. Nothing to do. Hallelujah. Just receive Him as the powerful one. Hallelujah. Just having fun at the back of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and just to possess all this promise. Behold, your God will come with vengeance, with the recompense, hallelujah, of God, which is Jesus Christ. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened. Hallelujah. You can see wonders. You can see the greatness. You can see the glory, the glorious event. Then the eyes, okay, and the ears of the deaf shall be unstopped. The lame shall leap like a deer. They will be strong at the time. The tongue of the dumb will sing. They will be singing, rejoicing in that city. Hallelujah. How glorious that is for all of us. Amen. Hallelujah. The parched ground, hallelujah, for the water shall burst forth in the wilderness. There's no more thirsty ground. There's no more, hallelujah, dry land. It all be watered by God. The parched ground shall be a pool, and the thirsty land spring of water. In the habitation of jackal where each lay, they shall be grass, reeds, rushes. The highway shall be there. The road shall be there, and shall be called the highway of the holiness. Hallelujah. In the book of Revelation, it says that we will walk in the path of gold. Hallelujah. Amen. Glorious day and glorious time, but it shall be for others. The unclean shall not pass over it, because this is prepared for those who receive Christ as their Lord and personal Savior. But it shall be for others, like all of us. Whoever walks the road, although a fool, shall not go astray. They will be guided by the Holy Spirit. They will be guided by the... No lion shall be there. But the Revelation says the lion will play with the lamb. As the mindset, no, that the lion is so dangerous, there will be no more danger down there. Hallelujah. No lions, hallelujah. No shall ravenous beast go up on it. It shall not be found there. Everyone will have its own peace. The place will be a peaceful place where you can play with lions. Hallelujah. Amen. And the ransom of the Lord shall return and come to the Zion with singing, with everlasting joy in their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and singing shall flee away. No more tears, no more hunger, no more fear, nothing but a joy inside the heart. If this word was written by God for us to prepare ourselves for the coming of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, hallelujah, we can possess all of this. We can start at 2016. Why wait for the time that the Lord will come? It is written. And it is given free to all of us. It's only how are we going to manifest that in 2016. Amen ba? The word of the Lord is so powerful that can manifest in every life. Hallelujah. God is so good. Amen? Amen. Zion, synonymous with city of God. When you read that in the Bible, it says the city of God. It is a place that God's love. Zion is Jerusalem, the city itself. No, the revelation says that Jerusalem will come down from heaven and will be placed on earth. This is the place of worship, that everyone who believes in the Lord Jesus Christ will go there and worship Him. This will be the place of worship. And you know the relation of this in the New Testament? Zion is the very presence of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So why wait for that time to possess what was promised if your Zion is the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ? It means to say it can be manifested in our daily lives. Amen bayon? Hallelujah. Let's give God a clap offering first. The word Zion is also used in theological and spiritual sense in the scripture. In the Old Testament, Zion refers figuratively to Israel as the people of God. In the New Testament, Zion refers to God's spiritual kingdom. We have not come to Mount Zion, according to Hebrews, says that the apostle, to Mount Zion and to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem. Not in the literal Mount Zion, but we come to the Zion itself, to the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. If we are talking the future Zion, which is the city of Jerusalem, now we can come to the very presence of God and possess what was promised in the book of Isaiah 53. Hallelujah. Simple as that. Peter, quoting Isaiah 28:16, refers to Christ as the cornerstone of Zion. See, I lay a stone in Zion, a chosen and precious cornerstone, and the one who trusts in Him will never put to shame. Hallelujah! This is what Peter is saying. The cornerstone of what Zion is all about, that city, the cornerstone of that city, is your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And when you have all those promises and you want to possess that in your life, He will not put you to shame. You can have it. You can possess it in 2016. Amen, Badon? Let's give our God a clap offering. Are you excited tonight? Isaiah 51, 11. It says, so the ransom of the Lord shall return, and we are the ransom of God, and come to Zion, to His very presence, with singing, with everlasting joy on their heads. They shall obtain joy, gladness, sorrow, sighing shall flee away. No more fears, no more tears, nothing at all. But God said, they will come to My very presence and enjoy what was promised to them. Hallelujah. And why wait for that time? If it is written, we can possess the very word of the Lord in the name of Jesus, it will manifest in 2016. That's how true that the manifestation of this word, if you will take it by heart. Place it inside your heart. Lord, I've read that passage. You said the ransom of the Lord shall return and come to Your very presence with singing, with everlasting joy in their heads, and they shall obtain joy and gladness. Amen. Who wants to have joy and gladness in their daily lives. Hallelujah. It's not available in the market anymore. Amen. Hallelujah. It's only available in the very presence of God. Last 2015, if we dare to be fruitful, all of us have chapters in our lives that we wish we could rewrite. Hallelujah. We make mistakes. Amen. We made mistake in 2015. We made a wrong decision. And if we're given a chance, we will rewrite all those chapter of our lives and says, I will just want to correct it. Amen. But we are not looking back in the past. We're looking to the future. The windshield is wider than the rear mirror. Hallelujah. We can learn from the past, but we cannot go back from the past. Amen. What we are trying now to consider is walking with God in the future, walking with God in 2016 with victorious life. Amen. Hallelujah. With life full of blessing. And I will not promise you that you will not undergo such trial in life. There will be. But I will tell you, there will be victory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. No weapon can form against you will prosper this 2016. Because the promise is greater than he that is in the world. Amen. Hallelujah. 2016 is a victorious year, an abundant year for all of us. That is the promise, not my promise, but the promise of the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let's give him a clap offering tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Getting over our past is so vital to our future. To possess greater things ahead, there are few things to aid to possess it. Hallelujah. This is very vital. Looking at the past, what I had done. Hallelujah. What was the mistake? Okay, this was the mistake. I will not bring this again to 2016. This is the point of decision. This is the decision making. Hallelujah. When I go there, I want everything in perfect shape according to God's pattern. Hallelujah. Amen. Shall we begin? I would like you to reframe it. Reframe each life. No one knows but you alone. Amen? No one can reframe your life. You yourself can reframe it. If there are some unsuccessful event in your life, hallelujah, if there are failures in your life, you cannot change the picture of the past. But you can change the frame. Amen? Thank you. Palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. Hallelujah. The picture can't be changed, but the frame can. So determine to see it differently. View it with a better perspective. Begin by asking, how did it make me stronger? Hallelujah. What is the effect of the trials in the past? This is the advice. Don't bring the fight that was failed in 2015 in 2016. I will tell you, you will fail again. And that is for certain. It will break your heart. It will break your mind. It will break your personality. It will distract you from serving the Lord. This is a new beginning. That's why it's a new year. This is not a refurbished year. New year. Hallelujah. This is not a coated with paint kind of life. This is a brand new life. What was in the past, stay in the past and learn from it and move to a brand new year. Amen ba? Makakaasa bang Lord? Hallelujah. Let's give our God a clap offering. What do I know now that I didn't know then? I don't focus on what you lost either, but only on what you've gained. Yes, we learn something from the past. And what we have learned there, bring in the future. It should be, you should gain out from what the trial teach our life. Hallelujah. There must be something out of it that you can gain from. Don't bring to 2016, hallelujah, the defeat that you have in 2015. Bring what was gained from there. Out of your checklist, what are those? Hallelujah. For us to have a sure, victorious life. A wise advice, look good and long through your windshield, your future, your tomorrow. But only glance through your rear view or your rear mirror. Why? There's always so much more in front of you than behind you. Amen? There's a lot of things to focus in the future rather than focusing at the past. There's no more focus on the past. We've learned so much from the past. And what we gain from the past, we bring it over to 2016. And what was lost, forget about it. Hallelujah. It should remain in 2015. Focus. See the windshield and not the rear mirror. Rearview mirrors are small, so only small stuff is behind you. Your windshield is on the other hand, is big and wide, and focus only on what's ahead. That's your future. You see, if it is the same defeat that you will have this 2016, you can think about it. You can imagine about it. What you have experienced in the past, you want to experience it in the future, I think it's not a good idea. Hallelujah. That's why we just left them behind and see and focus what's ahead. Learn and to obey the word of the Lord. And he says in the Message Bible, forget about what's happened. Don't keep going over old history. Be alert. Be present. He said, I'm about to do something brand new. Now let's return to the first sentence. Forget about what's happened. He cannot create a brand new things if your mindset is in the past. Are you getting the word of the Lord? Forget, you must forget the past. Don't keep on going over the old history. Then the Lord will going to do something brand new. Because you know why? If you have the mindset of the old history, it's a refurbished kind of life. It's just covered and patched up by the beautiful things outside, but inside it's a bone. Hallelujah. To have a victorious life in the future, God said, forget about the past. Don't dwell on the old history, because I'm bringing, once you are empty, once you are an open vessel, once your vessel is empty, God can put some abundant life and promises into it, a brand new life. How can God put something if it is full with 2015? God cannot do something about it. You have to discharge. Amen ba? We need to discharge. Amen? We need to discharge. Because he is about to do something brand new. And he said, it's not flowing. It's bursting. You must prepare yourself. Amen. Hallelujah. If you are aiming for something, prepare yourself. Pray. Have that intimate relationship with God. Keep on verbalizing that in the presence of the Lord, because it's bursting. It's not flowing. It's bursting. Hallelujah. Woo! That's why the book of Isaiah says, the parched land will be a pool of water. There's no more dry land. And it will depend on the mindset and of the heart and inside your spirit how to possess things that comes from God. If you believe that it will manifest, it will manifest. Hallelujah, because we are not living but what we see, but we are living by faith. We cannot see things. We're just relying on the word. We just place that in our heart, agree in our spirit. It is there. I cannot see it, but the word say so. I can see that there is a future, abundant future for me. Why? Because the word say so. Amen. Not your vision tell you that there is, but the very word of the Lord is saying, be strong and have faith on what I am telling you inside the word. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's give God a clap offering tonight. Woo! Reframe it. Change everything. Understand that you are still beautiful and complete no matter what. We made mistake in the past. We made mistake in 2015. We have decisions that ruins our day, our weeks, our months. Hallelujah. But we are not disqualified. He said, He still loves you. Hallelujah. How beautiful our God is. How awesome our God is. Understand the difference between guilt. I place it here for us to have a full view of what is guilt. Guilt is feeling bad about what we've done. This is healthy. This is how the Holy Spirit works in us. If we've done something wrong, there is a guilt feeling inside of us because the Lord don't want you, hallelujah, to stay on that condition of life. So there is a guilt. There is a reminder coming from the Holy Spirit. That is guilt. This is healthy. You cannot remove that from your system. But the shame, this one does not come from God. Hallelujah. The word of God says that He will not put you to shame. So shame doesn't come from the very word of the Lord. Shame is not healthy. Shame is toxic. Shame kill Judas. Hallelujah. Guilt save Peter. This is the condition of the two. So don't place or don't claim this shame inside of you and stay on with this word that will bother you in this 2016. This is not for us. Hallelujah. There might be a guilt which is very healthy, which we can come back to God, start all over again. But shame, if it strikes your life, just rebuke it in the name of Jesus. Shame is not for Christian. Hallelujah. Whether we choose to admit or not, all of us have things we'd like to change about ourselves. But keep in mind, when God created us, He saw everything that He had made, and behold, it was very, very good. It was complete. What I'm trying to say is that even though we make mistake this 2016, it doesn't qualify you, because in the sight of God, I made you perfect in my sight. Hallelujah. You may fail in one area, but you will not remain as failure. The hands of God will be there to pick you up and place you in a right track once again. He wants to give you the victory. All you have to do is what? To follow the very word of the Lord. He made our life perfect enough for us to have that joy to enjoy every day. So don't change the plan of God. Don't change the system of God. Don't input your ways to the ways of God, or else I assure you, there will be failures along the way. Hallelujah. What I'm trying to say is that He gives you the mind of Christ. You have the heart of Christ. You have the ways of Christ. Now, you only have to choose what to do, because inside of you is also your personality. Hallelujah. You have to choose whether you want to take the life of God, which is complete, or you want to deviate from that kind of life and input your own self. I mind you, if we try to input our own ideas, there will be a lot of mistakes down there. God wants us to follow His ways. For us to achieve a better 2016, please follow the guidelines according to the very word of God. If you get angry, hallelujah, remind yourself or tame yourself. Anger is not for God, not unless you're angry with the sin. That is a good and healthy anger. But if you are angry with, hallelujah, nonsense, take the very word of God. Remember Christ who has forgiven us so that we can forgive others. And also remind yourself, hallelujah, you don't know the situation of a person that you're talking to. And maybe there are some areas also in their lives that, hallelujah, that they committed such ways or action. Hallelujah. Just keep reminding yourselves with the very love of Christ. What I mean is, God had made everything perfect for all of us, that we can walk in that perfectness of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We can decide better things because He has given us all the wisdom that comes from Christ, all the knowledge that comes from Christ. 2016 is a better year for all of us if we allow God to move. That's why the Word of God said, I made it perfect, complete. Hallelujah. Nothing to add on. It's already there. All you have to do is to walk on it and you will have the success. Amen, Bayon. Let's give God a clap offering tonight. Glory. Hallelujah. So start seeing yourself as God sees you. Have confidence in saying, you're looking great this 2016. It's 100% guaranteed. Pwede ba nating sabihin yan? Can we say that to our neighbor? Hallelujah. You are looking good this 2016, and that is 100% guaranteed. Hallelujah. Kawawa naman yung hindi nakakarisiyo. Okay, one more. No, that comes from your spirit. Hallelujah. Say it with life. Hallelujah. You are better looking. You are looking good this 2016. Come on. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor. That's 100% guaranteed. Amen. And thank you so much. Hallelujah. 100% guaranteed. Why? Based on the word of God, not my word. Hallelujah. Number three, stop telling yourself, I can't do it. This 2016, you can do it. Or, if only. Hallelujah. I've learned so much from this very word. No, if only. What has been done is already my past. I don't talk about it. Not unless I gain something from it. Hallelujah. But if it ruins my life, forget about it. Hallelujah. You will not be remembered anymore. No? Sometimes this is the life of Filipino. Sayang. Kung lang sana. If only. Hallelujah. There's no if only with God. That is the past. Focus on the future. After stumbling badly, having God picked up, David, he wrote these words. Blessed, happy, fortunate to be envied, is he who has forgiveness of his transgression continually exercised upon him. He can see the forgiveness of God daily in his life. And he said, blessed, happy is the person who has been forgiven by the Lord continually. Wow. Hallelujah. So there is no if only. That will be your past. But the future is continually. There is a continuous forgiveness from the Lord. And David said, happy are those, fortunate are those people, because they experience continually. Hallelujah. Whose sin is covered, blessed, happy, fortunate is the man to whom the Lord imputes no iniquity and in whose spirit there is no deceit. Hallelujah. This must be the life that we have. This must be the feeling that we have. This must be the heart and mindset that we have. Blessed am I to receive a continuous forgiveness from God. Blessed is myself whose sin is covered by God. Blessed is myself, hallelujah, that the Lord imputes no iniquity at all. He sees me as white as snow. Hallelujah. So if this is what God is telling me, I can do it. Amen? Amen. Can we say, I can do it? Whoa, yun talaga, I can do it. One more, I can do it. In the name of Jesus, yes, we can do it. Hallelujah, this is the promise of God. BKK family, forgive yourself and forgive others. God has and Jesus did, because the Father sees you through the cross. You are accepted. And he said in Ephesians 1:6, to the praise of the glory of his grace by which he made us accepted in the beloved. This is what Christ has done to all of us. He forgave us. Amen? And the Father, hallelujah, forgave us as well through the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So the calling of God is that. Reconcile. Amen? Don't bring it on the 2016. Anything. Hallelujah. That can disrupt your service to God. Love them. Kill the hate with love. Hallelujah. It will give praise to the Father. As holy as God is, God accepted you. All of us. Who are you to argue with this final decision? Who are you to hold back your forgiveness? This is very, very crucial. Whew. I experienced this as well. Oh, it's always bothering you. You will see the face of a person. It reminds you of something. But with the love of God, everything can conquer. Hallelujah. Just tell yourself, if God has forgiven me, who am I not to forgive? Hallelujah. Simple as that. Okay? So don't stop. Tell yourself that you cannot do it. You can do it. And don't tell yourself that if only you can in the name of Jesus. Amen? You can in the name of Jesus. This is part of the 2016 Greater Things Ahead lesson that we have. Number 4, move from pain to gain. Healing takes time, so expect some anger, fear, sadness. But use this as your ladder towards your success. Hallelujah. Not a revenge, but your own success. If you fail to love 2015, conquer in 2016. Hallelujah. Increase that love. Amen? Increase the compassion. Increase, hallelujah, and it will give you success. First of all, spiritual life, spiritual battle. You will win and become victorious in Jesus' name. They're part of the process. Don't adopt them either in this 2016. Know when it's the time to move on. You can't walk back toward into the future. And the future God has in mind contains more happiness than any past you can remember. You see? If you already struggle in the 2016 and bring it over to 2015 and bring it over to 2016, you cannot focus on your future. Amen? Amen. Let's give God a clap offering tonight. Hallelujah. There's so much happiness to focus on in 2016, in the future. Just see through your windshield. Hallelujah. It has a bigger picture to give you than in the rear mirror that you are looking. Hallelujah. We learn from that. We learn from the past. And we bring it over what was gained in the past in 2016. Increase more in love in Jesus' mighty name. 1 Corinthians 6:19. Do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, the very sanctuary, the very temple of the Holy Spirit. If you are the temple of the Holy Spirit, you will have the fruit. And what is the fruit? Number one, spirit of love. Simple as that. That's why I'm encouraging you not only to read the word, apply it to yourself. Apply it to your mind. Apply it to the area which you are weak. And you can benefit out of it. I've tried that before. That's why I'm giving that to you. Hallelujah. I'm sharing it to you. Spirit is love, joy, peace. If there's no love, there is no peace. And there's no joy at all. Hallelujah. One will be missing, and that is love, which is, hallelujah, great, the greatest of all. Hallelujah. You may have faith, but without love, you cannot do anything. Without the love, there's no joy, there's no peace. You will not, hallelujah, there will be no long suffering. There will be anger. There will be no kindness. There will be no goodness. You cannot show kindness and goodness. Hallelujah. You will not look at them if you have hatred in the heart. But if there's love, you will have peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such, there is no law. This is the advice of the word of the Lord. Why? Because you are the temple of the Holy Spirit. And if you are the temple of the Holy Spirit, Paul said, finally, brethren, whatever things are true, love is true. Hate is false. Hallelujah. Why I say false? This should not be inside of us. That's why it's false. It's true. It does exist. But it should not be in us. Because we are the temple of the Holy Spirit and we have the fruit of the Holy Spirit. That's why Paul is also saying, whatever is true, whatever things are noble, things that are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are good of report, if there's anything virtue and if there's anything praiseworthy, just think of all those things. You will survive in 2016. Amen ba? Simple as that, right? Let's give God a clap offering. And as the temple of God, you need to daily remind yourself of the promise He made to another one in His temple. He said in Haggai 2:9, this temple is going to end up far better than it started out. Far better than 2015. Hallelujah. And it says, a glorious beginning, but an even more glorious finish. Hallelujah. This is for all of us. This will be your 2016. Remember, the temple of the Holy Spirit is pure and complete, made by God inside of us. If we have that, this follows. Hallelujah. The temple is going to end up far better than it started out. A glorious beginning, but an even more glorious finish. A place in which I will hand out wholeness and holiness. Wholeness, the abundance of the physical plus spiritual. Hallelujah. Are we getting the word? Hallelujah. Let's give God a clap offering. This is what it is all about in this 2016. The manifestation. That's why I told you a while ago, it depends on you how you will possess the word of Isaiah. If you are waiting for the coming of the Lord and Savior in Jesus Christ, then you can have it. But while you are waiting, then possess the very word of God. Enjoy what was given to all of us. For the Lord said, I will hand out wholeness physically and holiness spiritually. Both are abundant. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name, let's give God a clap offering. Woo! However good, bad, ugly your past was, Your future is guaranteed to be even more glorious finish because you are the temple of the living God. And his promise to his temple is certain, sure, absolute, complete. Hallelujah. This is the promise of the Lord to all of us. Are you excited? Yes. Hallelujah. Nakikita ko po sa mga mukha niyo. You are so excited. Parang this time, hallelujah, we want it this time. The last one. You must bury the past and start to live your promised future. Amen? Hallelujah. Very, very important. Rehashing old hurts is like watching the same movie over and over again. Hoping for a different ending, it's not going to happen. This is what I'm telling you. Hallelujah. If it is the same, repetitive, hallelujah, no corrective action on it, it's just like watching movie, the same movie, but what you have in mind is to have a good finish. It will not happen. The same movie is the same movie until the end. Hallelujah. Learn from it. Move on. You don't drown by falling into water. You drown by staying there. Is it true? Yes. You must pick up yourself and move out from the water. If you know that you are drowning, why stay there? Get out. Hallelujah. Peter denied Jesus 3 times, although a repeat offender. He finally got it right and preached his best sermon. That's why we're rich by the very word of the Lord, through Peter. Amen? Hallelujah. David was a repeat offender, yet he recovered each time and maintained his kingdom. Stop counting your bones. Hallelujah. Stop counting your defeat. Hallelujah. Count your blessing instead of sheep. Parang Christmas to, no? Count your blessing instead of sheep. And then I saw soon fall asleep, counting my blessing. Okay. That is the result if you are not in the music ministry anymore. Hallelujah. Compliments. Okay, start to live the promised future. When someone dies, people don't spend the rest of their lives hanging out in the cemetery. Is it true? Yes. Eating breakfast there, lunch, dinner, it's a grave site? Of course, no. All you have to do is just to bury that dead and move on out from the cemetery. This is your condition if you will not give up such thing in the 2015 defeat that you have and carry on to 2016. It will be a losing end. Hallelujah. God wants us to experience brand new life, 2016. Hallelujah. Amen. And that is certain. Amen. Hallelujah. You will possess that in Jesus' name. Jesus refused. He said, first things first. Your business is life, not death. In other contexts, you can say that your business is love, not hate. Your business is courage, not discourage. Hallelujah. Your business is to, hallelujah, encourage people, not to discourage people. He said, follow me, pursue life. These words of the Lord are just gelling with each other. We cannot take one from the other and do not do the others, because it will not gel anyway. It will not work that way. Because the word of the Lord is the word of the Lord. It nourishes the very soul and it gives vital strength to the spirit. If you take one and just take what you like, you know for sure that there is a lacking word down there. But if you take all and repent and tell God, Lord, I want to move on. I want to have a glorious kind of life in 2016. And you can have it because this is a promise. A promise is a promise. And God is not backing out from what has been promised to all of us. Hallelujah. It's up to you to receive or not. Amen. Hallelujah. This is all out given by the Lord. But he just wants us to do his business. A person that can give someone a life, a changing life. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Let's give God a clap offering muna. Revelation 21:5. And he who is seated on the throne said, Jesus, see, I make all things new. Also he said, record this in your mind and in your heart. For these sayings are faithful, accurate, incorruptible, trustworthy, true, genuine. Simple as that, no? Hallelujah. When I said in the book of Isaiah, what is going to happen to all of us? The bright future that we have with the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. God said, record that in your spirit. Because he's not telling a lie. He can be trusted. This is a trustworthy saying. Genuine, complete. Hallelujah. And this is not a refurbished kind of life. This is a brand new, abundant life. 2016 for all of us. Amen? Let's give God a clap offering. Hallelujah. Woo! Are you excited? Excited na naman ako. You know, I really had a glorious 2015. Every year, I enjoy every blessing that God has given, provided us. Really enjoyed. And non-stopping. No, 2016, simula pa lang, meron na kaagad. Why? Because of the very word of God. This is the promise. And we're just going to hold on to that promise of God. BKK family, greater things is ahead of you. Focus your way at the windshield. It's far more greater than anything we see in the rear mirror. Focus what lies ahead. And I want to encourage all that is watching right now, just focus your life in the future. What God has promised us will be given to all of us. This is accurate, genuine, true. This is the very word of the Lord. Hallelujah. And what was promised? Jesus promised us 2016 with best life that is yet to come. 2 Corinthians, whatever God has promised gets stamped, approved, yes to Christ. In him, this is what preach and pray, the great amen. God, yes or yes together, gloriously evident. God affirms us, making us a sure thing in Christ, putting his yes within us. By his spirit, he stamps us with his eternal pledge, a sure beginning of what is destined to complete. To God, this is a seal, no backing out, already stamped. Approve. You are blessed this 2016. Shall we all rise and shall we pray? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Let's give God a clap offering. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.